is termed as visual literacy. It involves certain grammar. Now this term is interesting. Usually by this term, what comes to my mind is English grammar, where there are set of rules which are made to understand a sentence or a poem. Same goes with cinema. There are semiotics, icon, indexes, etc. to understand a film. As famous Hollywood director Frank Capra said, film is one of the three universal languages. The other two is mathematics and music. Each film which has a purpose consists of symbols and language which create an ease to convey the narrative. There are wide variety of films from which semiotics or visual literacy can be understood. To understand this visual literacy, I have taken two films. One is Seven, which is directed by David Fincher, and the latter being Ankur, directed by Shyam Benegal. As we see the poster itself, it has a tagline, Seven Deadly Sins, Seven Ways to Die. The number 7 has a great significance, like God took 7 days to create this world, or the 7 wonders of the world, 7 colors in a rainbow, or of course 7 days left in the retirement of Detective Somerset. The movie starts with Detective Somerset getting ready for office. Good amount of focus is emphasized on how methodical, systematical Somerset is. The way he dresses up and picks his thing and gets ready. This shows that he is quite an intellectual, calm person, capable of taking control of anything which comes in his way. Like the scene when he is lying there in bits of peace, the external sounds from the neighborhood or the cars tries to hinder it. He uses metronome to take control over the sounds, thus restoring his peace. The way the city is portrayed, the film falls in the genre of neo-noir cinema. Despite of that chaotic, dusky city, he is capable of adapting. This generates a curiosity like what would have been the circumstances that have molded and shaped him in a character like he is today. This scene consists of reasons, as his background is funneled to us by the conversation of Somerset and Tracy. And if we see Mills, we got introduced to him on a crime scene where he is just talking. He is just opposite of what Somerset really is. And we can see calmness hasn't penetrated his core. At least Somerset finds his part of peace in his house. Mills can't even get it there, as his house keeps on vibrating every 5 minutes. Now if we talk about this particular guy, Kevin Spacey, his name in the movie is John Doe. John Doe. It seems like a name of a normal guy whom you can see anywhere in the park, in your neighborhood. Maybe he can be your college teacher. This normal name makes him dangerous. When we see Kevin Spacey, he just seems like a guy who can't even kill a mouse. His subtleness, his authority in committing those heinous crimes makes him so very dangerous. This whole film has many enigmatic codes. The enigmatic code in filmmaking is a puzzle which are set for the audiences to solve it. Like a usual crime thriller. If we see it, the main motive of the film is to catch the murderer. Here, in Seven, Kevin Spacey has surrendered on his 5th murder. It usually doesn't happen like this. The murderer has surrendered with 2 remaining murders. What would be his motivation or his next move? This sets a puzzle. There are many puzzles, many signs. Like the opening credits is a montage. We see close-ups of John Doe's hand, stitching bodies, peeling skins from fingers, etc. These are enigmatic codes. They play a vital role in conveying the narrative of the film. So with these signs, with these codes, with these indexes, when the movie ends, I feel like both Somerset and John Doe are quite same, but they are on two different extremities. Somerset, being intellectual, is kind and compassionate, while on the other hand, Doe, who is also intelligent, is revengeful and disturbing. We can understand visual literacy more clearly if we take a look on this Indian film Ankur by Shyam Banegal. The title Ankur suggests seeds, meaning the beginning. There are many scenes which can justify the term visual literacy in the film, but there is one scene which stayed for me. In this frame, we can see both Lakshmi and Surya standing in the shades of the tree. For us, they both appear to be black. Black means they are in some kind of problem and they are talking about it. But as we see Lakshmi retarding and moving away, natural light shines on her, while Surya is still in black. This scene defines the situation so perfectly that we can see clearly the motives of two characters. There are certain motives in the film as well. Motive plays a key role in conveying the narrative more profoundly. Seeds are used as motive. They convey one meaning or another. Like in the very start of the film, the seeds are offered in the temple by Lakshmi in order to fulfill her wish, which was to have a child. The thought of having a child is itself a seed.